closing in on first pitch in Oakland. The Mariners and the A's are next. Now from the home of the A's since 1968, it's baseball at the Oakland Coliseum. Today, a spring training matchup between the Seattle Mariners and the Oakland A's. A moment now to give you a look at the Mariners' starting lineup. Dero, daytime road game for them. What you got?
Matty, the key in this one for this lineup is they got to stay staunch in the middle of the plate. They can't start swinging at everything or this guy will abuse them. He'll start flipping up the rosin bag. They have to sit over those 17 inches and hold to that.
Sean Manaea gets the starting nod for the A's in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
The pride and joy of Andrain High School in Gary, Indiana. Sean Manaea, he had the no-hitter against the Boston Red Sox, one of the tougher lefties. He reminds me a lot of Sid Fernandez. Low three-quarter arm angle, mid to upper 90s fastball, good curveball, one of the top young left-handed pitchers in all of baseball.
All right, guys, so here's how the Oakland A's are lining up on defense for this one. And let's focus our attention on catcher Travis d'Arnaud. He's going to have to step up today and have a big game for these guys. Not known necessarily for his defensive acumen, more of a big pop guy on the offensive side. He has got to control this game.
Here's Dee Gordon now. He will lead this one off today. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. He couldn't catch up with the gas that time.
First pitch, 106.
Down and away, ball one. Great afternoon for baseball here. 71 degrees, the temperature at first pitch. The 1-1. Tries to bunt his way out here, but this is a foul ball. The 1-2 is a sharp slider taken low for a ball. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. In the bullpen area, he squeezes it to record the out.
Batting second, the center fielder, number 16. Domingo Santana.
Now at the plate, Domingo Santana. His career numbers against Manaea, he's only 1-for-10. First offering on its way. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Wind up and the 0-1. Zero. Swing and a miss, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is James Kingsley.
Hey, Dero, James Kingsley's a pretty good umpire. He doesn't get too excited, keeps things under emotions. He's a pretty good ball and strike umpire.
Yeah, James Kingsley will never show you up, and he's always approachable.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Lifted down the line in left. Pinder is after it, but this will land untouched. He Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Pitch popped up. Simeon waits on it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Mariners are down in order. Mariners nothing. A's coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. With that, let's look at the starting lineup for the hometown A's. What's the key for a home win here tonight, Mark?
Yeah, you take a look at this lineup they're running out today, and they got their work cut out for them with the sinker baller on the mound on the opposition side. They're going to have to see the ball up. They're going to have to work the home plate umpire. Can't be given 4 to 6 inches off the inside half, or he's going to have a field day pounding that sinker in there. Should be interesting to see right out of the chute if he's got the good one or not. Guys, here's Seattle's defensive alignment. And guys, what I want you to focus on today is this is one of the new age teams in the game that really rely on statistics and the numbers. And the numbers tell them that they're a better team defensively, moving guys around and shifting as much as they can.
Here's Tommy La Stella now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The designated hitter, Tommy La Stella.
Here comes the first pitch. Nope. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. Drilled right back up the middle. A dive, and he knocks it down. And a good try to recover that time, but he'll beat it out as he's aboard to kick off the inning.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, if you were in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Into the box now, Marcus Semien, line towards center field. Santana is right there, one down.
Batting third, the right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
So one gun in the inning here with the runner at first. And up next, the outfielder, Stephen Piscotty. First delivery to him on the way. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. La Stella, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
One of the toughest pitches to hit, the straight changeup, right? El Cambio. Hadn't seen it in that entire at bat. And what happens? Gets the string pulled on him right there. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Here's Chris Davis now. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. As a look, now the pitch. Fouled off. A runner on first with two away. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. One left for Oakland. We are still scoreless. So coming to the plate, Jose Abreu. His career numbers against Manaea, not great. He's 1-for-8. First pitch on its way. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
What a well-executed pitch right there. Just a little bit off the corner right there. Got a great hitter to go a little bit outside his zone.
The windup and the 0-1. And this is high, a ball and a strike. Abreu tends to exploit left-handed pitching. Many hitters are better against opposite-handed arms, of course, but he's considered one of the best hitters in baseball in these types of matchups. Oh, and this is hit high and deep out to left. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the left field wall. Oh, and the throw back in is a wild one.
Hey, there's a bullet off the wall. The outfielder does a really good job of getting that one in quickly, but I think they had a play there at second base.
Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on there, Dan. I got to believe you're busting it out of the box thinking two until somebody tells you no. I know it would have been a close play, but I think you got to err on the aggressive side right there.
Stepping in now is Mitch Haniger, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. A runner at first with no outs here. Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. The 2-1 is a heater in there for a strike.
2-2.
Here now the 2-2. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And that nearly broke our scoreless tie. Instead, it's a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. He stays alive, still 2-2. Good battle here. This will be the 7th pitch coming up. Front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Working for the punch out and the offering. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now, 3-2.
He's definitely going to want to get greedy in his zone, and he's obviously seeing the ball well, or he would have swung at that pitch. Sometimes in these long, epic at-bats, you start to get into swing mode.
Full count, here it comes. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for the first out.
A lot of indecision there on that check swing, and that's something you see quite a lot on 3-2. When the difference between striking out and drawing a walk can be an inch or two, it's pretty understandable why guys aren't always aggressive with their swings.
And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Runner at first here, one man out.
Strike this guy out.
Hit hard on the ground at first. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Boy, that's one of the, the advantages of hitting with that hole between first and second base, D-Row. First baseman has to hold that runner on. That leaves that right side wide open.
Yeah, and credit the batter right there. Nice piece of hitting right there. Not trying to do too much. He took a look at the defense and saw where it was aligned and tried to beat him.
Piscotty will drift over to his left a few steps as he takes it for the second out.
Batting it, the catcher, Omar Narvaez.
Now to the plate, Omar Narvaez. Twos all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Here comes the first pitch. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Abreu over at second. Anderson at first, two out in the inning. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Mariners leave a couple. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Striding in for Oakland, Julio Chacin, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. From the stretch. Started the breaking ball far too inside that time, laid off for ball one. Big swing and a miss at the changeup, a ball and a strike. Two and one to the A's first baseman.
Well, when you're behind in a count like this pitcher is, it's a good time to work in something off speed if you're confident in it. Most hitters are looking for fastball.
All even now, two and two. Set. Here's the 2-2. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. Chet Pinder will be next.
Come on now, let's go.
Now the payoff pitch home is swung on and missed, strike three.
I'll tell you, it's hard to get more of a confidence boost than striking out the best hitters in the lineup.
The left
back
fielder.
To back to back.
Yeah.
He's looking really sharp right now.
Winter.
Next up for the A's, Chet Pinder. His career numbers in this matchup, he's only 1-for-10. He's also been a strikeout victim 6 times. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Gets a good piece of it there, but this is foul off toward the third base coaching box. In there, strike two. And two count. Here's the pitch. This one's down to third. On to first, and there were two down.
Batting seven, the second baseman, Jerickson Profar.
Into the box now, Jerickson Profar. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. First delivery to him on the way. Outside part of the plate, the changeup is in there. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
That is such a tough pitch to lay off right there, but you have to find a way. There's nothing you're going to do with that low sinker except foul it into your shin or hit a ground ball to the left side.
Tried to get him out front, but it's a ball, 1-2. Bottom of the second here with no score. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
And it's fouled away. Line toward right center. That gets down, and the inning continues.
Outside of home runs, nothing fires me up more than watching a good baseball player drive the ball in the opposite field. Talking about hitting the inside half of the baseball, that's exactly what happened right there. And when we say inside half of the baseball, imagine the ball coming to a complete stop halfway between home plate and the pitcher's mound, and then cutting that baseball in half and highlighting the inside half. That's where you're trying to take the knob of your bat or the hands to that spot and carve the inside half of the baseball with power.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Kemp is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. One hit, one left. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. His career numbers against Manaea comes in with 6 hits in 30 at-bats. 2 of those hits were for home runs. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And the third inning begins with a changeup that misses. It's a ball and no strikes. Strike taken up in the zone. Seager, a 32-year-old veteran, he was selected in the third round back in the 2009 MLB draft.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on a superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
This is line to left. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And this will kick off the base of the wall. He'll get it into second. And a good decision to push it that time. He's in at second base with a leadoff double.
Managers these days like to think of that nine-hole hitter as the second leadoff man. And he plays the role pretty well right here. Gets the leadoff double. And now he gives the real leadoff man a chance to bring him home.
Digging in to try it again, D. Gordon. And he'll hit with a chance to push across the game's first run.
Yeah, great RBI opportunity here. But at the very least, he needs to find a way to advance that runner to third. Small things like that in a tight game can make a big difference.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. A ball and no strikes. And here's a fastball in for strike one. 91 miles an hour that time.
Pretty adamant about working him inside right now. Back-to-back fastballs, and that one was able to find the zone.
Seager stands at second with no outs. A ball and two strikes now.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Hit hard towards the hole. And that's through into left, a base hit. And they'll put the brakes on at third. Runners at the corners with nobody out.
Hey, this has the makings of being a pretty big inning, D-Row. Leadoff double, now a base hit, and all of a sudden we're looking at first and third.
Yeah, sometimes you wake up, you just get smacked in the mouth right here. He's going to have to start executing pitches. He cannot leave a ball over the heart of the plate right here. He's going to have damage on his hands.
Now a snap move over to first, and he's back in standing. Stepping in now, Domingo Santana, as he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1, and there are runners at the corners now. A line shot to third base.
Now batting, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
At the plate, Paul Goldschmidt. And he's got runners at the corners here with only one gone. Here's the first pitch to him. Loud contact there, but it's well foul. Third inning, no score to this point.
Nope.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
There's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike.
With two strikes and the runners at the corners, this is a big pitch coming up. Got to execute and hope to either get a strikeout or a double play ball to help you get out of this thing.
Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. There's one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're back to the Coliseum right after this. So that brings up the always intense leading Matt Chapman as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. He's set and the pitch. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Two and oh.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They didn't miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
Now the 2-0 home is taken, strike one. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. Here now the 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
3-2 pitch. Ripped down the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
batter, the designated hitter, Tommy La Stella.
Now in the box, Tommy La Stella. First pitch of the at-bat. And they go right after him on the inside corner for strike one. Sent on the ground out to second. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly.
He's in there.
Jeez, this looked like a routine grounder that just got away from him. Every school kid knows that you've got to look it all the way into the glove. He didn't, and now they've got to deal with a one-out base runner.
Into the box, Marcus Semien, as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Misses, ball two.
Well, you can see what he's trying to do right there. Double play situation, two balls down in the zone, trying to get that ground ball. Didn't get him to bite at either one. Now he's behind in the count, 2-0.
Too tight with that one. 3-0. Steven Piscotty will be next. Here's the 3-0. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup.
Good job of making him chase that pitch down below the strike zone. That's where you want to pitch when you're looking for the double play ball.
The 3-1 pitch. And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away.
Now batting, the right fielder.
Outfielder Steven Piscotty the next to hit. 0 for 1 here in the early going. First pitch coming. Here it is. Looked like the sinker there. Dipped a little below the knees. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. You can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
Now the 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
He's gotten himself into a little bit of trouble out here. Middle of the order up in a run-scoring situation, and now he might have to challenge him. Going to have to make some good pitches here.
A 3-0. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Three balls and two strikes for Steven Piscotty.
Two strikes.
Up. No problem over there for Goldschmidt, and there are two gone now.
The center fielder, number two, Chris Davis.
At the plate, Chris Davis. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Swung on and grounded, foul. La Stella at second. Semien on at first with two down. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
You know that nasty changeup's lurking right here. If I'm in the batter's box, I have to tell myself to stay back. I have to take pull side out of the equation, or that changeup's going to beat me.
Ready on 0-2. fouled away. The pause and the 0-2. The next 0-2 pitch to him misses outside.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Two balls and two strikes. The count to Chris Davis.
These are the great matchups that happen throughout the course of a game. I don't think as a pitcher you can give in right here. He's a great hitter at the plate. He knows it. You know it. Keep executing. Maybe get him to roll something over.
The set and the 2-2. And this one's in the dirt. And a good idea to hang close at first as he'll make it back easily. He sent the payoff pitch. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. And he misses with it for ball four. So the bases will be loaded now with two away.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
So striding in, Julio Chacin, one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Bases juiced now with two away. He's ready. Here's the first offering. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is really important when you're dealing with the bases loaded behind you. Good job to give himself the advantage there.
That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
Two walks in this inning already, so he can't expect to stay out there much longer if he puts somebody else on. We'll see if he can find it.
Right down the chute that time, 1-2.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
To two balls and two strikes now.
2-2.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
The payoff pitch. A bouncer up the middle. A diving effort as it's off his glove. And the run will score as the A's get off to a 1-0 lead.
Now back.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. Yeah. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. Pulls the string on that one. One strike.
We're only in the third inning, and his pitch count is above 60. That's not being too efficient with your pitches.
Bases are loaded here, two down. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball. Line towards center field. Santana is there to make the catch, and they'll escape the bases loaded jam by giving up just one run. The sights and sounds of a day at the ballpark. Oh my goodness. More from the East Bay right after this.
Mm-hmm.
Andrew Triggs will come out now and make his first appearance of the spring.
Number 60, Andrew Triggs.
Back with Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, as Jose Abreu is ready to start out the inning.
Abreu.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. A ball and a strike now to Jose Abreu. Outside, 2-1. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Right on the corner, 2-2.
Great spot with that pitch down and away. He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep hitting that spot.
The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Now batting, right fielder, Mitch.
Now at the plate, Mitch Haniger. His prior history versus this arm, he's a 333 hitter. First pitch of the at bat. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And there's out number two.
Now batting, shortstop, Tim Anderson.
So two are gone here in the M's half of the fourth. And up next, it'll be Tim Anderson. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. First pitch here is a sinker that runs a bit too wide. It's ball one. No runs, four hits, and one error in the ballgame for Seattle. Oh, this is hit high and deep out to left. A leap, but he can't rein it in. It's off the wall. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
And with that double, he's two for two and halfway to the cycle. Gave it a good ride, and that's the second time he's barreled up the ball. So he's seeing the ball really well. See if his teammates can pick him up and bring him home now.
So here's Matt Kemp now as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. The 0-1 offering. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. The set and the 1-1. Now this is driven out to deep right center. This could be trouble, and it is trouble. It finds the gap for extra bases. He pulls into second safely as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game.
Well, he was almost out of the inning. Did the last two batters showed him that you can't lose focus on the mound, even if you get two quick outs. Back-to-back doubles shows you just how quickly things can get away from you.
In now, Omar Narvaez. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. Narvaez, a Venezuelan-born ball player. He's a five-year vet at the major league level. Line drive, fair ball down the line. The runner from second crosses the plate.
And I can't blame the pitching coach for making that walk. That's three consecutive two-out hits here. So he's going to remind his guy that they just need to make one good pitch and get this inning over with. Let's see if the talk does any good.
In now, Kyle Seager trying to keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. First pitch is a curveball that's inside, 1-0. A ball and a strike.
1-1.
Nevarez leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Now this is on the ground here for Pofar at second. Throw in time and the side is retired. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors and a runner left on. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. The M's lead it 2-1. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, I talked to manager Bob Melvin during the break about his thoughts on the A's hitters to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. Jared Eichhoff, a 6 foot 4 inch right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 48, Jared Eichhoff.
Here's Jurickson Profar.
The Athletic. The second baseman, Jurickson Profar.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Here's a fastball on the inner third, taken for a strike. And he fouls this one off. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2.
Those 0-2 curveballs are really tough for guys to lay off. There's a reason it's such a common pitch in that count, but he did well to spit on it there.
Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2. Two-two pitch is fouled away. Another 2-2. Popped up. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Another 2-2 offering. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 fouled off.
Hey, I'm biased to the hitter right now. Keep frustrating that pitcher. Foul 12 of these things off. He's going to miss over the heart of the plate at some point.
Ready with another 2-2. He finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Now batting, catcher.
Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud. Career line against Jared Eichhoff. He hasn't had much success, just 2-for-11. Here comes the first pitch. And he misses inside with that one. Ball one.
That's a tough pitch to throw right there, that front door curveball. Just missed hitting that inside corner. That's a very difficult pitch. I'm not sure if he wanted to get that one down and away, and unfortunately, that one stayed inside.
Mine to the right side. That's his first base hit, making one for two now.
Hey, guys, he doubled up on that breaking ball. The batter obviously timed the first one. Second one, he was not going to let go. Good wood on that one, able to drive it for a base hit.
Standing in now, Matt Chapman, as he takes a called strike on the black. It's 0-1. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. To Gordon for one. On to Goldschmidt, and it's in time. A double play, and the side is retired. A's go quietly there. They still trail it here, 2-1. You say you're trying to reach the sky. You could do it all. It takes its time. It takes its time. You gotta work if you're trying to fly. You could do it all. It takes its time. Jarrell Cotton, please. The 5'11 right-handed reliever, enters to take over on the mound now.
Number 45, Jarrell Cotton.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, D. Gordon. He singled his last time up.
D. Gordon.
First pitch of the at-bat. Down the first baseline. This is foul for the first strike. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And he misses with it. 1-1. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys on this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
First pitch on its way. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Davis is under it. And that's the second out of the inning.
Now batting, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And stepping in, the power-hitting first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. Here's the first pitch to him. On a less than impressive swing there to start the at-bat. It's 0-1. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Nope. And he takes this one high, 1-1. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. And no one will track it down. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And a full count to Paul Goldschmidt. Three balls and two strikes.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Now the payoff pitch home. And no messing with Goldschmidt there, as he'll take first on ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried now to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough edges and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. Here's the first pitch to him. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1.
All one's the count.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Strike two as the hanging slider was let go.
We're seeing quite a few pitches up from him right now, and that can obviously be dangerous. A called strike there, but he might need to lower his sights a little bit.
And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. One left for Seattle. They lead it 2-1. Justice Sheffield, the lefty standing 6 foot even, takes over the pitching duties here. Now is the designated hitter, Tommy LaStella, a hit in two tries so far.
The designated hitter, Tommy LaStella.
And now pitch on the way. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Well, now the Mariners get some action in the bullpen as a left-hander's begun to get loose. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Right side, but it's well foul. Now here it comes. Softly hit here to the left side. And this will be no problem over with third, and there's the first out.
Now batting, shortstop, Marcus Semien.
Into the box now, Marcus Semien. It was a walk in his last trip. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And that misses for ball one. The 1-0. Is looked at for ball number two. Bases are empty, one man out. Popped him up. Goldschmidt has room in foul territory. Two down.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop-out. Well-executed pitch there.
Stepping in now, Stephen Piscotty. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. The 0-1 pitch. And this is high, a ball and a strike. One run, four hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now.
Great job on those last two pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball, and then he locked him up with a changeup.
The 1-2. Racks him up for strike three. A's are gone in order. They're down 2-1.
Ladies Paul Blackburn takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the A's, number 58, Paul.
Ready for another shot now, Mitch Haniger. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Leading off with the Mariners, the right fielder, Mitch Haniger.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. Into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Blackburn has proven to be a guy that throws strikes coming out of the pen and doesn't walk a lot of batters.
Boyd, every manager and pitching coach, Matty V, they love to bring a guy in that they know one thing. He's going to throw strikes and not beat himself. And this guy is certainly not afraid to attack the strike zone.
2-1 the count. And the pitch on 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. The 3-1 pitch. This is lined to left. Pinder is there, and he has it for the out.
Up next for Seattle, the shortstop, Tim Anderson.
Digging in now for the Mariners, Tim Anderson. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. First offering on its way. And it's fouled away. He looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
Two things pitchers really love: called strike threes and jamming hitters. How about that? Talk about that jam right there. That's about as good as it gets.
1-2, the count to the Mariners shortstop. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 1-2. Is a ball down and away. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there.
Now back.
Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Into the box, Matt Kemp. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. 1-2 in the ball game thus far. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might get a swing.
The 2-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Piscotty's there for it, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Mariners as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Wade LeBlanc enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 49, Wade LeBlanc.
So here's the Oakland cleanup batter, Chris Davis. Due up are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get something going.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far for them. They just haven't had consistently good at-bats.
set. Here it comes. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Prior outings against Wade LeBlanc, pretty average results, 4 for 15. He's taken him deep once. And he falls behind 0-2. Good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second time today.
The first baseman, number 17,
now Julio. Play, Julio Chacin. First pitch on its way. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he popped him up. Gordon ranges back, and he has it for out number two.
Up next for Oakland, the left fielder, Chad.
Stepping in, Chet Hinder. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips. Here's the first pitch to him. Fouled away.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the A's. Our score remains 2-1. Back here at the Coliseum in Oakland. The Mariners out in front of this one as we move to the seventh. But before it gets underway, let's give you a look at the game summary to this point. Liam Hendricks is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 16, Leah Hendricks.
Ready for another chance? Omar Narvaez. In previous meetings with Liam Hendricks, he's 2-for-4. Now here it comes. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one. Fastball misses away here. It's 2-0. Now the 2-0 home. Hits softly down the line at first, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. Swing and a liner. Foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch.
Three balls,
a full count. Three balls and two strikes.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. lifted down the line in left. And no one will track it down. Payoff pitch one more time. And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
Striding in once again, Kyle Seager, one for two with a double on the ledger so far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Great job of getting back in the zone with a hard fastball after the walk. I think he might have let a little frustration out with that pitch.
Nevarez aboard here at first with nobody out. Now a curveball, but he might have flown open a bit. It's one and one.
That curveball is a pitch you have to get on top of, or else it'll take off just like that one did.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. One and two now. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Yeah, and they set him up with that curveball on the pitch before, and that one, they just blew right by him.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Popped him up. Chacin over to his left. He's got it one away.
The batter, the second baseman, D. Gordon.
Eduardo Nunez will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning.
Eduardo Nunez.
And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Oh, on the ground to first. Can this be two? One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. It's stretch time here in Oaktown. It's the Mariners 2 and the A's 1. Eduardo Nunez will stay in the ballgame now as he comes on to play second here.
Now playing second base, number 36, Eduardo Nunez.
Anthony Swarzak gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Ready once again, Jurickson Profar. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
First offering on its way. And he fouls this one off. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Fastball well outside. Swarzak, a 6'4" right-hander. He's an 11-year vet at the major league level, so he certainly put together a nice career in professional baseball. The 1-1 home. Hit to third. Seager fields it cleanly. And a close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one.
Well-executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time. And that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Digging in and looking for more, Travis d'Arnaud. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. First pitch of the at-bat. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. And maybe a little frustrated on the mound here as the fastball misses for ball two now. Swing and a ball line down in the left field corner. But this is foul near the seats. One out, nobody on. Set to deal on 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Now the 3-2 pitch. Fouled off. The next 3-2. High in the air out to center field. Santana is there. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Up next for Oakland, the third baseman, Matt Chapman.
Stepping into the box, Matt Chapman. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least. So you know he wants to make up for it right here.
And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. Two out, nobody on. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line in right. And that's in there, base hit.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way. Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player. Fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Number 57.
So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. Dominique Montano will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Dominique Montano.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
As a hitter right here, you have to tell yourself, I can't get too big. Don't let the moment get away from me. A nice bullet in the gap gets the job done in this situation.
Chapman is off of first with two away. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. And not too shabby out of the pen. Takes just two pitches to get the ground ball, and that ends the inning. The A's strand one. They still trail it here 2-1. Daniel Gossett's been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ryan Healy is going to be asked to get things going here as a leadoff to top of the eighth.
Ryan Healy.
Fastball in there for a called strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Mine to the right side. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit.
Last pitch was a fastball. Tries to double up with the same piece of cheese, and it gets turned around. Nice piece of hit.
Goldschmidt.
Daniel Vogelback will come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out.
Daniel Vogelback.
First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. line toward the gap in left center. And this will be just what the manager ordered as he's off the bench with extra bases. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
Now batting.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
Mikey Mazza will come on to pinch hit here, and if they don't walk him, he'll have a great RBI opportunity with runners at second and third and nobody out. This one up, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. Our pitcher's duel continues here, 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Line toward center field. Davis the catch, tagging is the runner from third. And to score is the runner from third. It's now 3-1.
Every team is looking for that insurance run late in the game. That run right there gives them a two-run lead heading into the late innings.
James Morin will grab a bat and pinch hit now, and he'll be looking for at least a fly ball as he's got a runner at third and only one away.
Morin.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Davis is under it. Two gone. And even with two away now, that ball just didn't get out there deep enough, so they'll hold him at third base.
The shortstop, Tim Anderson.
J.P. Crawford will be charged with the job of getting that guy home as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at third. That one bends into the zone, a strike on the breaking ball. Runner in scoring position with two gone. One count. Here's the pitch. Tough one to call there, but it's ruled just above the zone. He pops it up. Chapman in foul ground, and no one will track it down. The 1-2 gets him swinging. He struck him out. M's pick up a run on two hits. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. Seattle leads this one 3-1. Daniel Vogelback will stay in the ballgame as he'll take over at first base.
Number 20, Daniel Vogelback.
James Morin will stick around as he'll take over in right field.
Morin.
J.P. Crawford will stay in the ballgame as a new shortstop.
Crawford.
Jacoby Jones will also come in now as he takes over out in center.
Jones.
Franklin Barreto will try and get his club back into it here as he'll pinch hit to lead off the home half of the eighth. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one and it's strike one. Malone, a California-born ball player. He was taken in the 10th round during the 2008 draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
popped up. Vogelbach is there for it. One away. A good afternoon of spring training baseball thus far as you get a look here at our line score through the first seven. Matt Olson will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. Here comes the 0-1. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Eighth inning of this low scoring affair, 3-1 our score. Inside and a hair low, it's two balls and two strikes. Now this is foul tipped right into the catcher's glove as he holds on to preserve the strikeout, and there are two away.
The center fielder,
Corey Guerin, enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Mariners, number 35, Corey Guerin.
Josh Begley will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. Now that's popped up, and eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. A's are gone in order. They still trail it here 3-1. Franklin Barreto will stay in the ballgame as a new shortstop.
A defensive change for the Athletics. Now playing shortstop.
Matt Olson will stick around as he'll take over in right field.
Now in right field, number 28, Matt Olson.
Frankie Montas enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Ramon Laureano will also come in now as he takes over out in center. Stepping up to the plate, Matt Kemp. He flew out in his last at bat.
Matt Kemp.
First pitch on its way. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here, nothing in one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And it's 1-1. Montas stands 6-2 and throws from the right side. He's a five-year vet at the major league level. And it's 1-2. Swing by Kemp and a bouncing ball to short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Up next for Seattle, the catcher, Omar Narvaez.
Digging in, Omar Narvaez. He enters this at bat, 1-for-2 with a walk. First delivery to him on the way. No balls and a strike to count. Bases are empty, one man out.
A
This is on the ground over to first. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And the recovery is too late as he's able to beat the throw to first.
Hey, not a bad pitch right there. Off-speed pitch down in the zone. You thought he would set that up pretty well. The previous pitch was a real good fastball up.
Yeah, I think the hitter was sitting all over that one, Dan. I really do. He saw that fastball up for show. I think he thought to himself, here comes the off-speed.
In now, Kyle Seager. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Hit out towards second. Reined in to second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. 5, 6, and 7 will lead things off in the bottom of the ninth. The Mariners are on top, 3-1. Your Dan Altavilla is the man called now on to close this Seattle. One and earn a save
number
in the ninth.
53, Dan Altavilla.
Leading off the inning, Julio Chacin, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Julio Chacin.
Here comes the first pitch. Ball one, as the changeup misses well off the inside. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing.
Well, these hitters can expect to see a heavy dose of that big fastball from this reliever. It's a major part of his arsenal.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Jones has a read on it. One out.
Oakland. The left fielder,
Nick Martini, will move into the on deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning.
Nick Martini.
And he'll lay off a fastball here in a good spot, but ruled the ball 1-0. The 1-0 home is looked at for the first strike. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. One out, nobody on. Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1. On deck, there's Jurickson Profar. And he lays off. Ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count. The ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Pitch of the at bat, and a fastball is in there for strike one. Oh, one. Here's the pitch, and a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Martini, base runner at first with one out. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. bouncer to the left side. There is Seager. Nunez. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
The batter. The catcher. Travis. Gargano.
Striding in, Travis d'Arno. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. From the stretch. Didn't quite catch the zone there. Ball one. Now the 1-0. And it's fouled away. Now the 1-1 pitch misses for the second ball. Two-run game, last of the ninth with two away. Hit hard to short. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Well, as a former pitcher, you know I love these low-scoring games as opposed to those slugfests. This was like a throwback game when home runs weren't so common and pitching was really dominant. No complaints here.
3-1 the final score this afternoon. The Seattle Mariners took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Marco Gonzalez is credited with the win. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Seattle Mariners. 3 runs on 10 hits. 1 error. They left 9 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 44 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.